Myself, Professor Rajan Chaudhary from Department of Civil Engineering, IIT Guwahati. At the very onset, I would like to congratulate Construction Industry Development Council and Indian Society for Trenchless Technology, supported with other organizations from India and abroad, for organizing this wonderful India Construction Week 2020 and online international conference and exhibition. My topic for today's presentation is Reviving Highway Industry in Post-COVID Times, a focus on the use of alternative materials for sustainable construction. Now, many of us are aware that India has a goal of becoming a $5 trillion economy, US dollar economy, which specifically rests on the construction of critical infrastructure under the National Infrastructure Plan. The Indian construction sector employs around 49 million people, which is close to 12% of the nation's working population. So it plays a very, very important role in providing employment to the youth of our country. Now, during this COVID pandemic, most of the construction works came to a complete halt, specifically during the lockdown period. And it is estimated that around 85% of the infra companies faced reduction in revenues in the range of around 55 to 65%, specifically in the April-June quarter. So, and a total projects having worth more than 59,000 billion, which are under development, were got severely impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. Now, during this pandemic, specifically the air and public transportation acted as facilitators and carriers of the COVID-19 virus at global as well as local levels. So now, most of the times, we all keep on saying that transportation infrastructure is vulnerable to natural hazards, specifically the hazards in terms of earthquakes, in terms of landslides, in terms of flood. But this COVID pandemic made us to realize that how anthropogenic hazard can substantially disrupt the transportation system. So the transportation system, which used to earlier facilitate the smooth and safe movement of passengers and goods, this time acted as a facilitator and carrier for the COVID-19 virus also. But on the other hand side, road infrastructure played also a very critical role. How? Because it ensured the delivery of essential goods and services. It ensured the medical and proper medical and a timely medical and emergency health services for the infected and affected people. Evacuation of citizens away from the affected areas and allowing first responders to access the affected areas. So even though it facilitated the spread of the COVID virus, but then along with that, it played a very, very important role, specifically while tackling this situation. So on this basis, we can say the transportation and health sector complement each other. And with the reduction in the transportation demand, as always taught in the very first lessons of the transportation engineering, that travel demand is a derived demand. It depends upon the demand for the different type of travels, specifically for work, shopping, etc. So this demand got reduced, and because of which a lot of losses in revenues were experienced by the transportation sector through the losses in terms of the toll taxes and in terms of the cess to be obtained from petrol and diesel. So there was a huge revenue loss which was also faced during this COVID-19 pandemic period, which is still ongoing. You can see here in these two pictures the situation during the lockdown and the situation before the COVID-19 strike to our country. And with the road infrastructure and the air infrastructure, which played a very, very important role, we can see how within in the starting few months it is spread to almost 170 countries, affecting the six continents with population. The heavy engineering sector will play a very important role in reviving the economy. This pandemic makes us to think seriously to bring in sustainable highway construction materials as well as technologies for long-term benefits. There is a huge need specifically to focus on how to make our highway infrastructure resilient, reliable, and sustainable. Highway projects in post-COVID times must embrace payment technologies that are inclined towards lesser dependence on natural resources and promotes the use of alternate materials to derive maximum economy and ecological benefits amid the resource constraints. The resource constraints after the post-COVID period or in the post-COVID period will be in terms of the resources, financial resources, as well as the resources of natural resources, which are at present also. So these, the constraints will be more, and we have to definitely seriously look what type of different materials and technologies can be used for reviving the highway engineering sector and to make our construction more sustainable. So in this my presentation, I will be discussing, I'll be focusing on two important areas, in which first of one is use of steel slag aggregates in the design and preparation of open graded friction course mixes, where we I'll be sharing some of our findings where we have explored the use of steel slag aggregates in OGFC mixes, and we acknowledge the support which we got from Department of Science and Technology for carrying out this research study. And second aspect which I'll be discussing in this presentation will be on use of waste plastic in bituminous mixes, specifically with respect to PET. We did the work here at IIT Guwahati on utilization of PET in bituminous mixes. So these two materials and their incorporation, how we worked out as an alternate materials in the bituminous mixes, will be discussed in my presentation. One major challenge which we are currently facing is the shortage of good quality of aggregates. Now, with the growth in the financial economy, it has led to an inevitable increase in the demand of aggregates in the civil engineering construction. Currently, the annual global consumption of natural aggregates is around 50 billion tons. That is predicted to increase at an annual rate of around 5%. A large-scale mining and consumption of non-renewable natural aggregate resources leads to severe environmental and economic concerns. Many regions in the country there are many regions in the country where the mining and extraction of natural aggregates have been banned because of the environmental concerns. And in many regions of the country, we are facing crisis specifically with the availability of good quality of aggregates. So there are many regions in Northeast also where we are not able to get good quality of aggregates. So there is a big crisis. Now, with the crisis after post-COVID in terms of financial, then there will be crisis in terms of natural aggregate resources also. So there is a high requirement to look for some alternate materials and waste materials in road construction so as to achieve the sustainability. So we need to explore different alternate and waste materials which can be possibly utilized in our road construction. Now, when we were looking for alternate materials which can be explored for road construction, steel slag came out to be one of the promising aggregates. Why? Because it has many favorable characteristics, especially in terms of its good strength, polishing resistance, high specific gravity, hydrophobicity. So these makes it a potential candidate for use in bituminous mixes. And in terms of the steel production, India ranks second in the world for the amount of steel production which takes place. Now, with the amount of steel production which specifically takes place through two major type of furnaces, one is basic oxygen furnace and second is electric arc furnace slag furnace is there. So two types of slags are normally generated, and there is a very large quantity of slag, as it can show by the Ministry of Steel report 2018. So around 12 million tons and 5 million tons. are getting generated from both the furnaces. And out of this steel slag which is getting generated, only around 20% is getting utilized, specifically in cement manufacturing industries or in construction in sub-bases and base courses of payments. So they are getting underutilized in that case. Huge quantities are lying in steel plants, specifically unutilized. So in our study at IIT Guwahati, we targeted for utilizing the steel slag aggregates as a replacement of natural aggregates in open graded friction courses. Now, why we targeted open graded friction courses? First of all, what is an open graded friction course? Here you can see these are the two types of surfaces, pavement compositions which have been shown. This is the most common composition which is seen on flexible pavements, where we have a dash graded surface. So whatever the surface water, rain water, storm water, which falls on the surface, moves on the surface with the help of the camber or the cross slope or the super elevation to the sides. Now, because these top wearing courses are impermeable surfaces, so they don't allow water to permeate inside the pavement structure. It moves on the surface with the help of the cross slope or the camber. So this is how the surface water is removed. Whereas in the case of open graded friction courses, the surface water, the rain water, storm water is allowed to enter the top surface over a dense graded surface is a porous surface. So it allows the water to enter into the surface, and then with the help of the cross slope, the water moves within this particular surface layer. So there is no water which is going to exist on the surface. Whatever in this particular case, intense graded surfaces was moving on the surface will move within the surface. So here you can see, if a water is allowed to fall on a dense graded surface, a usual dense graded surface, then it doesn't enter into this particular slab. Whereas if it is allowed to fall on an open graded friction course, then it passes through this particular course because of a large amount of interconnected voids which are there. Now, the difference can be seen in this particular manner. If there is a rain, then you can see when a dense graded surface is there, you can observe an existence of a thin film of water on the surface, because it takes water to time to drain out and to get the surface completely dry. Whereas in case of an open graded surface course, you can observe there is no standing water which is there. There is no standing water on the surface which is there. It appears more or less dry surface. Similarly, these two surfaces further differentiate between an open graded surface and a dense graded surface. During a rain, or you can experience with the movement of the heavy traffics, a lot of splash and spray get generated, because of which the visibility gets reduced. Even a lot of glare is there because of the presence of the film of the water. And then the another major challenge is with respect to the reduction in the skid resistance. Because of the reduction in the skid resistance due to the presence of a film of water which results into hydroplaning, the probability or the chances of road accidents increases. And this becomes more challenging during rains in night times. So this is always a challenging situation. People who are driving in heavy rainfall regions or regions where frequent heavy storms are there or rains are there. So this is quite a challenging situation. So in that particular case, if an open graded surface is there, then the splash and spray is not there. Visibility is also good. So we targeted open graded friction course for a replacement of natural aggregates by steel slag. Because why? Open graded friction courses, since to have a high amount of air voids, they to get the required strength, they rely on the stone to stone contact, and they demand good quality of natural aggregates. So we thought, if we are able to attain comparable properties with the steel slag in OGFC, we can similarly, it can be expected that they will show a comparable properties in case of dense graded mixes, because the requirements are quite high in case of open graded friction courses. They require, in OGFCs, we require more angular aggregates, we are more resistance to crushing and polishing. These surfaces are used even in many countries to improve the skid resistance, because they have a very high polish, they have a very high friction resistance compared to a dense graded surface, and they even help in are used in many countries to reduce the noise levels also. So they have many additional benefits in terms of reduced noise pollution, in terms of reduced splash and spray, in terms of increased skid resistance, in terms of increased visibility. So there are many advantages which are associated with OGFC mixes. But yes, they are, these mixes are comparatively costly than your dense graded. So these are special mixes which are, which can be considered in an option specifically for heavy rainfall regions. So they demand good quality of aggregates. They demand stiff binders specifically because more amount of air voids are there. So, and these mixes are in regular contact with the water. So they demand a more water resisting surface and a more aging resistant surface. So then many a times various additives are also used in these mixes in terms of hydrated lime to improve their moisture damage resistance, and fibers to improve to reduce their drain down, which is a common problem specifically in case of OGFC mixes. So we worked out to possibly explore the use of steel slag aggregates in OGFC mixes. So when compared with the natural aggregates, the one which we obtained here from our nearby regions, we found that both these steel slags showed very favorable characteristics, especially in terms of the shape, angularity. It showed a very good high specific gravity and a high impact resistance also. Then a detailed investigation was done for various levels of replacements from 25% to 50%, 75% and 100% replacement was done, and an intensive experimental program was formulated, and where we went up to 100% replacement and evaluated different characteristics. When some of the findings I am showing here, so when a replacement was made with BOFST slag, and we looked into the improvement of the moisture damage resistance, because as I said, these aggregates have a hydrophobicity nature, so they form a good bond, and then they have more porous structure and rougher surface texture. So the addition with the binder was found to be much better when compared to the natural aggregates. So they showed a very good resistance to moisture damage compared to the natural aggregates, and even the permanent deformation resistance measured in terms of the rut depth was also found to be very good specifically with the replacement of steel slag aggregates. And one another aspects, different aspects were evaluated. Even we worked out with the permeability, how, because these mixes need to be permeable to water, because they act as a drainage layer. So they demands a permeability of normally more than 100 meter per day, which was achievable with all different replacement percentages. And even we worked out with the, because the clogging of these surfaces takes place. So with the different ways of declogging, how much permeability can be restored? So different levels of studies were done, and we are fortunate enough that in 2019, Indian Roads Congress came up with the guidelines on OGFC mixes. So now the highway construction agencies are open to make use of these special mixes depending upon the requirement in a particular region. Now the second interesting topic which I want to pick up for the sustainable road construction, which we should now target, is the use of waste plastics in hot mix asphalt. Various research efforts are continuously going on in different parts of the country as well as in other developed countries also, because it's a challenge to all developing as well as developed economies, because there is a huge growth in the plastic consumption, and specifically because socio-economic development is there, rising urbanization is there, and this product is widely used, having diverse applications in packaging and industries. So it constitutes a major portion of the municipal solid waste. So reuse of waste plastics in asphalt materials will be both environmentally viable and environmentally friendly, because it will help to reduce the amount of waste plastic which is lying unutilized, and it will be economical also, because it will be free of cost, and if it is able to give us comparable properties, then it will be economical also. Now, different types of plastics have been explored, like a polyethylene terephthalate PET is there, which is mostly used in packaging of water, soft drinks, food items. This have been explored by different researchers in different ways, because a very high consumption of PET is there, and a very high amount of PET waste is available in different part of the countries. So a good amount of research effort is going, and under the current pandemic also, because a lot of plastic waste will be generated because of the increased demand among the individuals, and especially in the health and the retail sector. So more number of waste plastic will be added to the environment even during this pandemic period. So we have to look for some sustainable applications of these waste plastic. Now, normally different processes have been tried by different researchers and different groups. They can be quantified into three main headings. One is a wet process, where the waste plastics are blended with the bitumen, and then thereafter it is mixed with the aggregates. So what is done in that particular case is a wet process, where a bitumen is blended with the plastic, so it is mixed, and then this modified bitumen is mixed with the aggregates. So that gives you the final mix. So we call it as a wet process. Then a dry process is there, where the hot aggregates are first mixed with the waste plastic. So we have a mix of an aggregate plus a plastic. Thereafter, the binder is added and we get our bituminous mixes. This is the dry process. Then many researchers have looked for a modified dry process, which is also there. What is done here, as in the case of a conventional mix, the heated aggregates are mixed with the hot bitumen, and thereafter the waste plastic is added to finally get the resultant mix. So different processes have been tried for different types of plastics, and some of them have found to show good performance with one process, but may not be with other process. So we have to explore. And also currently good amount of research is already available. We have also done a good amount of work specifically with the use of waste PET in bituminous mixes. Now their use in bituminous mixes will depend upon up to what content we are trying to look for their use and what sizes we are incorporating. So the content and size of waste plastic plays an important role, in addition to what are the different ways in which they can be incorporated. Here you can see different processes have been tried. Dry process, modified dry process have been tried, because for PET normally the wet blending process doesn't work. So one of the results of the studies are shown here, where different contents have been explored and different sizes of PET have been explored. But the interesting finding is that with the incorporation of the waste PET, we are able to get comparable and even good performance of our bituminous mixes. So in this way, we can save our environment, we can save our natural resources, we can reduce our dependency on natural resources also, non-renewable resources also. And Indian Roads Congress came up with the guidelines IRCSP 98 specifically, which is on the use of waste plastic in bituminous mixes through dry process only. So as I said, different plastics need to be worked out through different processes with respect to different sizes also. So continuous research efforts are going in country at different levels to incorporate these waste plastics as well as the through different processes in bituminous mixes. So with this, my concluding remarks of this presentation will be that transportation engineering plays an important role and will play an important role to mitigate the negative effects of the current pandemic. So fortunately, the pandemic didn't affect the physical infrastructure of the transportation. This is what, because as I said, it is vulnerable to the natural hazards. But this time, rather, it was affected by the human aspect of the transportation system, so which was not expected. So now we have to understand the connections between transportation system and its users, because as I said, this worked out in both the manners. Transportation system was one of the facilitator for the spread. On the other hand, it played a very critical role in reviving from this pandemic also. So we need to explore different materials and different technologies for sustainable road construction, like a use of steel slag, use of marginal aggregates, use of waste plastics, use of other industrial waste in our road construction to make our construction more sustainable and more environmental friendly. So use of alternative or waste materials and technologies in payment should be encouraged to derive the maximum benefits from the perspective of economy and environment amid the constraints imposed by the pandemic. A lot of constraints will be coming up, are presently also under this pandemic period, and definitely post-COVID also there will be various challenges in front of the highway construction sector. So we have to come up with these innovative materials and technologies to revive back our highway infrastructure. Now I'm sharing some of the important publications which have been there in this particular region on use of steel slag and use of plastics in road construction, which we have tried at IIT Guwahati. So with this, I would like to thank all of you for your patient hearing. So we hopefully, I expect that during the India Construction Week, there will be a lot of deliberations among different sectors, industrial sectors, government bodies, as well as educational sectors, to look into different ways through which we can revive back our infrastructure, specifically during this period and after and the post-COVID period also.